A mi tierra mexicana, yo le canto a tus volcanes, a tus praderas y flores, que son como talismanes del amor de mis amores. México lindo y querido, si muero lejos de ti,
Awesome, ladies and gentlemen. Hope that came out nice and clear for you. That music is so beautiful. We're moving right along to Africa here. As soon as I turn that down. And next, I have Miss Bylon that's going to introduce the next bit. Do you want to talk about that?
Yeah, so this is the first year, at least since Mr. Lapid and I have been hosting Culture Night, that we will be having the Black National Anthem performed. So performed by Brandy Bell Alexander and Queen Bell, who are part of our Bell family. The Black National Anthem was written in 1898 by poet and school principal James Weldon Johnson and his musician brother John Rosamond Johnson. This song was written after the end of slavery during the Jim Crow era to inspire African Americans to be proud of themselves, their culture, and their community, as well as to encourage other Americans to treat the Black community equally. As we listen to this beautiful performance, let us honor George Floyd, Ahmaud Arbery, Breonna Taylor, who would have turned 27 today, and the many other Black men and women who are no longer with us because of racism and injustice. And let us remember that Black lives matter.
Thank you so much for that, Ms. Bylon. If you guys can get your link and browser ready, we're gonna get things started here in 3, 2, 1.
All right. So Mr. Lapid's having some technical difficulties. I'm going to start and take over and see if I can get this going.
Difficulties, but we're gonna get started with our first student performance, which is by Jesse Lopez, a seventh grader here at Bell Middle School. Mia, can you go ahead and introduce the next performer?
Jesse L, also known as DJ Jesslo, is Bell's resident DJ. He couldn't be here today, so he put together a culture night mix for our listening pleasure.
Hi guys, my name is Jesse Lopez. I go to Bell Middle School. I am a seventh grader, and today I will be DJing for you.
Consider it.
Bye.
All right. Hey, I'm back, and I'm sorry about that, ladies and gentlemen. That was Jeslo, DJ Jeslo, and how young he is and how much talent we have here. We're about to get into the acts from the staff and the students now, so thanks for bearing with me on that. Thank you, Mr. Maxroff and Ms. Bailon, for covering on that. But let's go ahead and move on to the next piece here. Let's see. We are currently now at the point of Mr. Rahim. Don't ask me to wait. Can you explain that a little bit, Mia?
So here's a spoken word by Mr. Rahim. Don't ask me to wait. It's not really
awesome. I really appreciate that. So we got Mr. Rahim. As you may know, he's an entertainer. He's one of the greatest. And he's also a spoken word artist. So let's hear a little bit of what he got, shall we? All right. Let me share once again, and I hope you guys have the link. Get ready to see a little Rahim action.
Don't tell me to wait no more. I want my justice now. I won't wait until the by and by. This is how it goes down. As a kid, I waited for the tooth fairy, but she never showed up. I waited for Santa Claus with cookies and a doggone cup. 9 months, my mother waited for my birth, while my father, he waited for the law. My grandmama said, let him grow up to be a man. But Jim Crow said, hell no. Now it's 2020, and you want me to wait 400 years without preparation? At least treat me like a Japanese and pay me my reparations. Don't tell me to wait no more. I want my justice right now. I won't wait until the by and by. This is how it went down. While waiting to be freed, I was shackled and stayed, sold to the highest bidder, branded like shot in the head. Now I'm waiting on a new name. They deemed me and called me lazy. Without the language and history of God, that can call me crazy. So don't tell me to wait no more. Not 1 second more. It's my time is at hand. Liberty and justice for all. I won't wait to be called a man.
That is Mr. Raheem with a spoken word. Now, ladies and gentlemen, what did you get from that, Miss Lori Bylon?
That was very powerful.
Very powerful, wasn't it? The title of the song again was Don't Ask Me to Wait. Mm-hmm. Any interpretation thoughts on that?
I think especially during this time, you know, talking about not asking him to wait for justice to be served, not waiting for equality, I think is what he's talking about, because his community and his ancestors have suffered enough.
Absolutely. Well, thank you for that. You know, Mr. Raheem, we worked together really closely, and we have some commonalities, you know, and one thing that we do like to share with our people about culture is spoken word, and we have a common sense of hip hop. So I would like a little piece with you all, and I'm gonna go ahead and get this started here. Now, unfortunately, I don't have a video, but I do have this visual, okay? Feel free to chime along if you like. What we're trying to communicate these days is sometimes people are going out there reckless with the protesting and whatnot, but we don't want to be a fool. You know, people got to keep it cool and just stay in school, right? So we got to ask them, what are they going to do? What are they going to do to do? Okay. So if you want to follow along, please do. Enjoy. It might be a little choppy, but I hope you get the message. What you gonna do, what? Just stay in school, what you gonna do? I'll be getting on, trying to be strong. What's going on with this new rap song? Filipino teacher, known as the preacher, looking at me like an instinct creature. Rapping the West, dealing with the stress with my bulletproof vest. You gotta try hard and gain some freaking knowledge. Maybe one day you can use it in college. Pass my class, work with the math. I'm freaking check, dropping a dime like KD and BB.
Gotta give shout outs
to the family.
Natalie, Andy,
what's up?
Gotta give a real love
for the man above.
And y'all know,
times are tough, man.
And y'all know,
we gotta take a stand.
And y'all know,
I love my eggs and spam.
And y'all know,
hey, I'm Filipino, man.
Don't be a fool.
Gotta keep it cool. Just stay in school. What you gonna do? Come on.
Don't be a fool.
Gotta keep it cool.
Just stay in school, what you gonna do, right?
Right.
I know there's a lot of crazy stuff going out there these days.
Mm-hmm.
But please, keep it cool and don't be a fool. And ultimately, stay in school. So what you gonna do? That's my word. Think about it. You know.
I hope you guys enjoyed that. Just want to share some culture there on the hip-hop underground spoken word tip and relaying a message there. So I hope you guys enjoyed that. Now from the different staff, we're going to move on, and we're actually going to go ahead and ask, who is this? We have Miss Roberts. Who has Miss Roberts here? I hope you guys have Miss Roberts. She's so awesome. How about Mia? Shed a little light on what Miss Roberts is trying to do.
Miss Roberts is going to be dancing an Irish traditional dance called...
Sorry, go ahead. Repeat that.
Miss Roberts is going to be dancing an Irish dance, a traditional Irish dance. Miss Roberts is going to dance a traditional sit dance called Job of the Journey Work.
All right, and hopefully you guys have your link ready on the side of your chat. Feel free to open up a browser and get this link up there. This is the amazing Miss Roberts.
Thank you.
All right, that was Miss Roberts. And just like Miss Roberts, you got more talent here. We actually have Miss Carpenter as well. And by the way, earlier, I just wanted to clarify in regards to my comment with the protesters, not the protesters acting the fool, there's some other fools acting the fool. Anyway, just want to clarify that. Mia, did you want to talk about Miss Carpenter? Mia?
This is about teacher Miss Carpenter and her husband Mr. Price. This is East Coast Swing Dance to the song All I Want for Christmas Is You. Enjoy these Christmas feels.
Thank you so much for that, Mia. I'm sorry about that. It's a little lagging. All right, hopefully you guys all have your browsers ready. Here we go. You guys are clapping with your hands full. That was awesome. Now, for those that don't know, every year Miss Carpenter comes through with her husband and represents that culture and dance over there. So it's a holiday dance, but it's definitely needed right now for some cheer and holiday spirit. So moving right along here, I hope you guys are still with us there. Pardon the hiccups and the technical difficulties, but we're getting back to our flow. And we're going to go ahead to another teacher, Miss Mora, in her church. It's the Tree of Life. Do you want to talk about that, Edmund?
Yes, I will, Miss Rockford. So basically, this dance was performed at the 2019 Masoniac Jewish Alliance Conference from their local San Diego congregation, Tree of Life. They practiced learning the dance for 2 months after the service because they are on the worship. Darcy Liberman, Born a Sheer Puppy, will also translate to Come to the Waters, a song by Bach Ribba Witten. It is a Hebrew song, and Pashut means simple and extended in Hebrew.
All right, thank you for that, Edmund. Now, if you guys have your link and browser ready there, we'll get started with this in 3, 2, 1. Sharing. Miss Mora, there she is, right there on the right there. That's Miss Mora. Awesome. Where are we at? Let's see. Next, we currently have Mr. Rahim sharing some more talent, okay? And these are some of the teachers now. I saw that group dance there, and it looks like similar to some cultural dancing that we'll be doing later, okay? So at the end of the program, we still have a nice surprise for you as well. So you want to go ahead and introduce that, Edmund?
Yeah, so before I start, I want to give like a fun fact. So basically, community drummers who are open to teaching the language of the drum over 100 years accumulated experience from this. Also, drum circles are and drum lessons are a healthy way to make connections and build communities.
That's right, Edmund. Thank you so much for that. So if you guys want to get your screens ready for this next link from YouTube. Okay, that's... Oops. let me go ahead and get my screen share here. And we'll go ahead and get this started in 3, 2, 1. There you go, from Mr. Raheem. That's his drum circle. Now, I know I miss those days when we're going into school in the morning to wake us up, to get us energized. We got Mr. Raheem playing the drums at the front of the school. You guys remember that? Those are some good times that I do miss. You know, we had heard from a student, you heard from some staff, but we're going back to hearing from the students, shall we? What do we have next, Edmund?
So basically, the next video we're going to watch is one of my personal classmates slash friends. His name is Dakari. So basically, in this video, he's going to share his talents of piano, and also he's going to be dancing to the song Falling by Trevor Daniel.
Awesome. I appreciate that. So you have a class with him?
Yeah, English.
That's awesome. All right. Do you see the link on the chat there, Edmund?
Yep.
All right, well, let's get our browsers ready. Let's go ahead and get your clips if you want a more smoother stream on your own browser. But feel free to watch and check this out. Here we go. Let me go ahead and share my screen. Sometimes I have to remind myself by telling myself out loud, you know? So thanks for bearing with me, guys. Here we go on the count of 3, 1, 2, and 3. Y'all may know that song. Who knows TikTok videos? That's TikTok videos right there, huh? Yeah, that's culture. Yes. Thank you.
And a backflip. Woo! Talented. Talented from the piano to dancing to flipping. Wow, we got a lot of good talented students out there. We have another one coming up as well. Edmund, you want to set that one up?
So basically the next video, which is called Stray Cats Jazz Dance, it basically in this video is a girl named Amber. She's a sixth grader here at Bell. She's performing here in Arts in Motion, also known as AIM Dance Studio, in El Cajon, right there watching. Amber is the one coming out of the trash bin in the back, if you pay close attention to the video. She then moves to the front row in the middle.
Awesome. Thank you, Edmund. Now, you see the link in the chat there?
Not yet. Hold on a second. We gotta wait for it to respond and post it.
I will post the link in the chat. I just wanted to show you a picture of Amber and her dance partner because it's hard to see her. So that picture I was showing was Amber. And then I'm going to put the link in the chat now.
And do you mind just keeping that picture up? Sorry, I did a screen share, but I don't need a screen share this one. So you can go ahead and put her picture back up if you don't mind. And I'll go ahead and play the audio in about 5, 4, 3, 2.
Lapid, you need to show the video for this one.
Oh, okay. So I do need to share. Okay. Yeah. I was like, I thought you could just hear the audio as well.
No, it's a dance.
Thank you for letting me know. Here we go. That was a nice picture of her there and with her partner, right? That was her dance partner. Awesome. Here we go. All right. Get ready in 3, 2, 1. Thank you.
That's something that's real special. And I think Miss Miller is here, and she used to do the drama club, or she does the drama club. I know we missed those performing arts and on those stage performances. That was so beautiful. So thank you so much, Amber, for that. We're going to keep it moving here, and we have a musical piece that will be from a seventh grader here. Let's go with Jessica. Are you there?
Yeah.
All right. Do you want to read off what's next?
Ilian G, seventh grader, is representing Moroccan culture by wearing a djellaba, pronounced in the videos. His video shows him playing the soundtrack of Daredevil series on piano. He chose this piece because he likes the show, Flash movie, the music.
Awesome. Sorry about the audio there. All right. And I think he's still here as well. So we have a celebrity in the building here. This is awesome. Thank you so much for bringing this. So if you have the link on standby at the chat, we'll go ahead and get ready with that. And I'll share my screen here for you guys, and we can get started with this next piece in about 3, 2, and pardon me on that one. 1.5. Okay, go. I'm going to repeat that there. Daredevil the series, that's right.
Ilian, that was awesome. Piano skills again from Bell Middle School students are just amazing. Wow, congratulations. That was nice. I think mom is there with them too. How are you? That was awesome. All right. Well, you know what? We're getting down to the end of our program here. We got a couple more stuff here. Thank you for bearing with us. We probably got about 15 to 20 more minutes, maybe 30 minutes, but hey, I'm glad that we are on the flow. This one is kind of special to me. It's Eddie Basila is an eighth grader of mine that I got to give you a little background on this one. He shared this video when he was a kid, when he was a child with his father singing a song, and they kind of redid it. So I'm really happy that he came back to share this with us. So you want to introduce that one, Jessica?
Eddie Basila is an eighth grader at Bell Middle School, and his tatay, his father, sings a Filipino song called Kahit maputi ang buhok ko, even if my hair is white.
That's awesome. Cool. Thank you so much for that. Now, if you have the link there ready, I will follow along. We can all follow along together, or just go ahead and check this screen out as I share it. We're going to get things started on this clip in about 3, 2, 1. How many of you guys do karaoke, huh? That's a nice setup. Culture. Culture. Aba, magaling. Good job, Eddie and Tatay. Diba? All right. Well, that was great. I'm so proud of him. I'm glad he came through. I was worried he wasn't, to be honest. So I'm so happy that he, and now I'm getting a little emotional because I'm going to miss everybody. Oh my gosh, it's getting to that moment, isn't it? All right. So let's keep moving on here with some good cultural reflection as well. As you guys know, Culture Night is no longer in person right now, but I did want to reflect on the traditional culture of Tinikling. Jessica, did you want to talk more about that?
Yeah. Tinikling is a traditional Philippine folk dance which originated during the Spanish colonial era. The dance involves two people beating, tapping, and sliding bamboo poles on the ground and against each other in coordination, with one or more dancers who step over and in between the poles and the dance.
Awesome. Did you finish reading that?
Yeah.
Perfect timing then. This is great. All right. And I know this video, I'm actually going to ask you guys if you guys are using the link to prep it to about a minute and four, because all of that is all of that is going to be waiting around for a moment. So here we go in three seconds. There's 104 is where I'm queued at. If you guys want to queue your browsers and stream, and I believe I'm sharing okay. So here we go. 3, 2, 1. Thank you. I missed that energy. Oh my gosh.
Mr. Lapid, I think some of these performers are with us today.
Hey, what's up, Miss Byline?
I think some of those performers are with us today. Aliana. I think maybe there's a Lana in here. I don't know if it's the same Lana.
I think there was a Jacob. Hey, Jacob, you are awesome recovery off that little hiccup there, and that.
Why are you calling him out? Don't call him out.
Because he is awesome now, and he can. is awesome.
Also, Miss Santiago is here.
Miss Santiago is here. For those that don't know, Boone Elementary is our feeder school, and we have a little pipeline going on with our cultural dancing. And I'd like to give a little shout out to Miss Santiago. If you guys can just show her some love, you know, wave at her. Ms. Santiago, thank you so much for being here, because the next bit, actually, so that was a traditional tinikling, and something that Ms. Santiago does at Boone Elementary is start them very young, and I know even Ms. Hubbard's child has performed with you, but they have a special version, and we're going to check that out. Did you want to share a little bit about that, Jessica? Jessica, you still there?
Yeah.
Awesome. And you went to Boone Elementary yourself, right? Okay. Having a little bit of hiccups there. I don't know if Jessica's freezing, but Jessica, did you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, so you went to Boone Elementary as well, correct?
Yep.
And what do you want to describe is coming up next?
It's a revised version from Boone Elementary by Miss Santiago to Bell Middle School. It's by students.
And what do you have to say to Miss Antigel right now?
We miss you lots. I wish that we can perform again for your girl tonight in Boone.
Here's the thing about wishing. You can make your dreams reality. So let's make sure we keep that, because you're recorded and documented now. Okay, so you have to do it. Just kidding. But one thing I do want to share is that we go to Philam Fest, which is another partner that we work with is SCPA. And they also have this event called Philam Fest, which is the Filipino American Festival. Every October is Filipino American History Month. And at this time, if you can get that browser ready, I'm going to go ahead and share my screen. And we have a modern version of Tinikling. Now, some of you already know this, but let's share it to the people here today, okay? Check it out. I miss tapping. Thank you. MJ, rest in peace. Go, Natalie. Go, Hazel. Go, Jessica. Go, Nick. Is it Marnell, too? Let's get it. Applause, yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, Bell Middle School women to nickname modern dance Michael Jackson's They Don't Care About
Us. Woo, that was pretty epic. That's pretty skillful. Just want to say that that is amazing. And I got to give a shout out to the Filipinas, the strong women out there. You guys are killing it. I hope that you continue that same bond in high school and represent even stronger and harder because you guys are going to be awesome.
Shower with?
Whoa. Okay, sorry about that. That's a little glitch there. So let's see. Let's keep it going. We're getting down to the nitty gritty here. Get ready for a group epic Dal Sayo dance. But before that, let me explain a little something that's going on in the world today. We all know that there is coronavirus, right? And it's very tough to be happy at these during these times. But there is a diva personality, Vice Ganda, that I'm going to ask Jessica to elaborate on and kind of share a little bit of what that is.
Jose Maria Borja Becerral, born March 31, 1976, known professionally as Vice Ganda, literally means beautiful vice, is a Filipino comedian, television presenter, actor and singer, a strong advocate for LGBTQIA culture and community.
That's right. Thank you so much. Now, there's a craze going on, and I don't know if you guys know about it, but have you guys heard of this thing? What's the name? I forget what it's called. It's so new to me, and I don't understand it sometimes, but it's TikTok. Yeah, TikTok. Let's see. Ms. Bylan, do you have a TikTok?
I do not have a TikTok.
Oh, you don't have TikTok?
I don't, but you know, summer is coming and I'm going to be stuck inside. I might just end up getting a TikTok.
Right, and bored. You know what? TikTok has all these like issues now. I mean, there's copyrights, right? When you put on YouTube, they're trying to say that you can't post things. But however, we're going to need to serve justice on this and kind of show the people some TikTok because it's history. And Vice Ganda is a TV personality, as Jessica read. And I try to upload user YouTube video, but it got deleted. But hey, I got it on my Google Classroom, so check this out. So I'm gonna pull up this link right here. What's that? Oh, don't worry. Oh, sorry, Jackie's Ginang is getting excited because she knows what's coming. But anyway, so there's a TV personality in the Philippines, and they came out with this fun little craze dance, and I'll stop talking and just show you. Here you go. Check it out. Hopefully it'll show okay, but... Now, just like that, now I just want to make sure that you guys were able to see that and understand that. Basically, the words are saying, Corona, bye-bye, go away now. You're very distracting. You're bad. Go away, kind of thing. And now that Miss Bailon has committed to doing TikTok videos, I'm waiting for Miss Bailon to do that video, okay? So here's some inspiration, Miss Bailon. We do have our students. Online learning is kind of the thing. How do we deal with all that's going on, and how do we make it educational and provide awareness? Well, here you go. You can make it into a video project. And our twins here, Hannah and Dee Bonita, seventh graders, have their own expression. Check it out. Aren't they cute? Aw, now, you know, when we started doing online, here we are having Zoom meetings, we're having dialogue, and guess what they did? They challenged me. They said, Gino on Lapid, you. So I'm like, what? I'm going to have to serve justice and try to. So here it is with Gino. Check it out. I had to get creative, guys. So I'm trying to get through Corona, you know what I mean? Here we go. The things I do for you, students. Okay. So I'm glad that's done, but I really wanted to just share that with you guys because it really brings light to what's going on. And, you know, I'm just really proud and happy to be able to have this experience with them. So you got to make the best of it, you know, and that's why we're here today, to celebrate all the different cultures out there. So we're getting down to the end here, but I need your participation, ladies and gentlemen. So get ready, because I have another thing that I want to break down for you. And we brought some culture to Bell Middle School, even lunch times, did we not? Do you students want to share what we did or what we learned in Filipino class? Natalie, can you share, please? What dance did we learn? Okay, you're on mute. Great.
Okay. Hey. All right. We learned the song.
Go ahead.
We learned Dahil Sa'yo, which means because of you.
Cool. And then Mia, can you read the rest of that description?
So Dahil Sa'yo means because of you, created and composed by, I'm sorry if I said that wrong, which became a major hit in the Philippines and also became a Zumba dance that we might be performing for you.
Maybe so. And Mia, I think, has a little knowledge about this, right? So what I'm going to do for you guys, I want you guys to pay attention closely, because we're going to end off with a little activity, okay? And you're going to have to really pay attention to some of these moves, okay? All right, let me go ahead and screen share for you guys. Hopefully the link is there with you guys, and I will screen share momentarily. Here we go. In about three, 2. And if you guys already know it, go ahead and warm up, people, because, you know, it's coming. Get room. Make some room, people. Put your video on. So we're going to mirror those moves, okay? So it goes right, left, up, turn around. Here we go. So you go to the right, left, right, right, left. Right, left, left. Shake it off, shake it off, shake it off. Right, left, forward, up, turn around, and there you go. Right, left, right, right, left, right, left, left, right, left, right. Throw it out, throw it out, throw it out. Right, left, right, right, left, right, left, left, left. Last one, here we go. Okay, we're getting there. We got 41 people. Okay, so that's cool. Let's try this. So here's the thing. We're on Zoom. It's gonna be a little difficult, right? And am I still over there? Okay, good. However, we can do it. And I'm gonna show you another clip real quick. And I hope you guys are getting your practice on. Let's see, where is that next one? There it is. So here we go. If you were able to get some of those moves, we actually been practicing it on Zoom, and pardon the non-synchronization or barely, but just check it out. It's possible to do. And we're gonna try to end off with this. So let me go ahead and screen share. I'm learning here, guys. Thank you again for your patience on this. But it's down to the bitter end here. So let's end off with a bang. Here we go. We're gonna have to coordinate. I'm gonna do a little tutorial on something real quick for 1 minute after this, but check it out and get your screens ready. We can be Workout right now, so you guys gotta stretch out. I hope you guys are stretching. Now, mind you, we just did that like what, Ms. Bailan, 2 or 3 times? We just practiced really quick for that. So it didn't really take that long. So here we go. We're going to end off, by the way, there's a video that I want to share from you from the staff. So don't go nowhere, okay? But if everybody can now, at this moment in time, sorry, I have long hair now. But if we can go ahead and make some space, I'm gonna just do a quick tutorial and I wanna do a quick assessment here.
I was watching, Mr. Lappet, I was watching the teachers. I saw, you know, Miss Mapala was doing it.
Oh, she already knows.
Melody.
Here we go.
Garcia, Mr. Lewis, you're ready.
All the hosts there, can you guys record this part? Okay, this is gonna be very special. So. Let's just review real quick and do a couple basics. So I'm glad to hear that you guys are getting down on the get down already. But let me just, everybody, if you can raise your left hand. Let me just see if everybody has a left, because sometimes you might have an opposite in there. Let me just go real quick. Just keep your left hand up. I appreciate that. Left hand up. For anybody comfortable to put their left hand up, I appreciate that. Okay. And if you guys, now I'm going to tell you a little thing here. If you want to do this sitting down, I'm going to show you some moves and you could just sit down and still do the hand motions and still be a part of this. Okay. So we need to first off know that this is the left side and this is the right side. So it comes out a little mirror. Now it's real easy for it to do. All you got to do is go right, left, and then you pull down, right? So let me back up a little bit. That's right, left, pull down. Okay. And you go left, right, pull down, left, okay? So let's try to just do that first step just to get that synchronization. And you guys pretty much know it already. Everybody else just follow along and I'll show you a little bit more hand movements before that. So here we go. Let's just practice real quick. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3. Are we all there? Then left side. I know it looks right on my side, but left here, then, sorry. Then left, right, left, left, okay? And then you're gonna do this part, you're gonna do push it, which was push it to the right one first, right guys? Are we doing push right? Ms. Bailan, that's correct. Push right, push left. So it goes right, left, right, right. Yeah, you could just do the movement. You could just right, left, right, right. Okay? So you just kind of move with it, groove with it, kind of get that step in.
But it's basically a right, left, right, right, left, right, left, left. Push it, push it, push it, push it. Now, Natalie, did I push the wrong way? Is that right? Is it right this one first?
I think we're all going to be opposite because we all have different configurations. So just
that's what I'm saying. That it's okay. So
go with it. There's just go with it.
All right, let's do it. Okay, I like that. All right, enough said. Appreciate it. So let's go ahead and just see how this turns out. So if you just want to throw your hands in there and wave like this, that'll work too, right? Okay. So I'm going to get my music ready here. Hopefully, put in technical difficulties once again, but we're almost there. So, you guys got first link. That's the best one to practice with. So choppy, okay. All right, here we go. I'll share my screen and go, okay? So hopefully it records, okay, the gallery view. Pew, pew, pew. All right, here we go. So if you guys want to go ahead and kick off your video screens at this time and get down with get down. You can't see me? That's okay. You don't need to see me anymore. It's all about you guys. All right, here you go. Right, left, right, left, left. Push left, right, left. Right, left, right. Right, left. Left, right. Push up, keep your hands up, pull it down. Run it out, here we go. Let's try it again. Right, left, forward, up. Right, left, right, left. Push it, push it, push it. Left. Push it, push it, push it. Push it, push it, push it. Raise your hands up. Do some things. Inspiration. Right, left, right, right. Thank you. Throw your hand left hand, right hand, left hand, right hand. Put your hands up, pull it down, give the inspiration. Right, left, over, 15. Last one, here it is. I don't know how that looked, but I sure felt it.
Yay, so, that was great.
Thanks, guys, for participating on that. Hope you guys enjoyed that. Ms. Garcia, you got a good workout over there? All right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're coming down to the final piece of this, so I just want to thank you for your time. And really appreciate it for just making this happen, everybody. So we, as a staff, came together and tried to put a little something special for our students. So Ms. Byland, a description on that real quick for me. Sorry.
Sure. Miss Galloway really led this, and she had her son Zane put together a little video. The staff wanted to just encourage our students and families to stay positive and be happy even during this tough time. We miss you all, and we can't wait to see you all next school year. So this is the happy video to Pharrell's.
Thank you so much, Ms. Bailan. That was beautifully said. I know we can all second, third, fourth, fifth, all that. So thank you so much. Once again, spread that good cheer. Here we go. Here, enjoy this link. It should be in your chat momentarily. And if it's not there already, this is our happy video, Bell Middle School. Enjoy and have a great rest of the evening. Go, Miss Hubbard. Yay! Oh, share screen? Am I not sharing screen again? I'm so sorry. Here we go. I'm getting excited. Hey, you gotta love authenticity, right? Here we go. Giving all my love there. Here we go. Hey. Congratulations, Ms. Rivera, on your new baby. Oh, yeah. Let's stay happy, y'all. Look at the beautiful queen right there. There's another one. Hey. Michelle, be Ms. Mora. Ms. Rivera. Come on, Ms. Nice backyard.
Hey, Miss Hara and family. Or Mrs. Adagini. Miss Garcia and family. Love you, dog. And there you go, you got the queen again. Parting their nest in the subway. Back out there to get a Lewis, that's how you do it. And get out of the way. Oh, we should do that dance next, huh, guys? Miss Wells, fitness and training. Miss Wells, such a queen as well. Don't mess with her. Beat your butt. And you know the hype man right there. And beautiful queen. Miss Jones. Miss Mora, thank you for participating. No other than Miss Hubbard and fam. There you go, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, I just want to say thank you once again. I hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you so much, Marami Salamat. Ms. Bailan, did you have any final words, Mr. Megstroff, or any students want to say anything?
I just want to say thank you all for joining us. I know this was all kind of last minute, but we wanted to make sure we still continued the tradition of Culture Night, even though we're not together. Hopefully next year we don't have to do it this way, even though, you know, Mr. Mekstroff, Mr. Lapid, students, we did it very, you know, choppy, but we did it. So thank you all for joining us. And we're going to post the links to the videos on the website next week, and hopefully this recording also.
Eighth graders, we'll miss you. Seventh graders, we can't wait to see you. Sixth graders, you know what's coming. So, Marami Salamat again. Thank you so much, everybody. Have a great night. Peace and blessings. Appreciate y'all, Bell family. Appreciate it. Bye.